When BuzzFeed started, we were this little lab in Chinatown. We were experimenting in New York City. We were experimenting with ideas. We didn't really think of ourselves as a business. And we started to notice that we could do these amazing things with no resources. We could reach millions of people making fun little things. And the reason is that the internet had unlocked all of these awesome opportunities that people hadn't figured out yet. And that the internet allowed the consumer to have these benefits that were so great that you could have a fraction of the resources of all of the big media companies and still make things that were hits that would reach tons of people. And really, we started, without really realizing it, to build a company around human connection. And how do you make content that allows people to communicate and connect with each other better? But who's going to make all of the content for this massive global network that people are consuming across all of these apps? Is it just going to be user-generated content? And internet trolls and fake news, which was something that we saw a lot of this election cycle, where there wasn't as much content being made for digital. Attention shifted there, but there wasn't really an investment. Or is there going to be a massive amount of content creation made for these new platforms? And that's what we're betting on at BuzzFeed. The way that things worked in the past don't work anymore when consumers see how cool the internet is and what it can do for them. So, for example, if you look at media, and traditional media, the old pre-digital world, a studio would make a giant film or a television show, or a newspaper would print out a newspaper, or a magazine would print out a newspaper. Everyone gets the same thing, and it's slow, it's expensive, and it's not personalized. If you are reading the news, you have to get it the next day, or a week later if it's a magazine, or a month later if it's a monthly subscription. And it was a good business, but because there wasn't the internet and there wasn't an alternative. But once the internet comes along, you start to see that there's other things that the internet can do that are not possible in traditional media. So this is very early. I think companies started to realize that you could give people instant access. So a print newspaper can't give people instant access. But a web publisher can keep publishing every second or anytime there's breaking news. You can have almost free distribution. So instead of having to pay to print something, you can, or pay satellite retransmission fees, you can deliver your content for basically free, which opened up all kinds of new ad-supported media where you didn't need to charge the consumer a lot of money. The other thing the internet has unlocked for BuzzFeed and many other companies is the ability to have all of our content live on and have consumers be able to access our entire archive, which is a huge advantage that you don't get in traditional television or traditional broadcast. At BuzzFeed, another piece of this to us is we make content. So we actually have a creative team of people who see the data about users and what they like, and then can use that as part of their creative process to make content. So if you think about a traditional studio where you make some giant movie and you release it 2 years later and you don't know if the audience is going to like it and you pray and you hope that it's a hit and sometimes it is and sometimes it isn't, that's not a very good process to serve the consumer. If you think about how it works at BuzzFeed when we launch shows, like we have a show right now gets about 10 million views for every episode. Every time we do one of those shows, we get all this feedback from the audience. And so they're in constant engagement with the audience and they get better and better at making stuff, and so their creative process is informed by all of this user data that's coming back and allows them to make better content. So I think that's a huge piece. But the piece that I think people still have not wrapped their heads around that I think is more important than anything is social and the way social has changed media. So if you add on to the advantages I just mentioned, that people can take things they like and share it with a friend, and that they can make media part of their lives and part of their friends' lives, it opens up a whole bunch of new possibilities. I think the industry is just starting to figure it out. So if you are a media company or a consumer company, you are never going to be as close to your audience as they are to their friends or to their loved ones or to their family. So if your focus is like, I want everyone to love my brand and think I'm the greatest thing in the world, you're competing with someone's friend, you're gonna lose. People are social animals and they care a lot about their friends. And if you make media that they can use to share with their friends and connect with their friends, you're going to have a deeper connection to audiences' lives than any other possible way. And it also becomes a form of distribution. It also drives growth. And if you look at even the most traditional media companies, they're all indirectly, without even realizing it, changing their whole strategy based on social media. So think of the big studios. They only want to do giant tent poles because they're events that people talk about on social media and gather around. Or they only want to do films that are tied to fandoms, like superhero fandoms, because there's a built-in community of people who will talk about those kinds of things. Or they only want to do live sports because there's the fans of the teams who want to be in the moment at the same time and share an experience and do tailgating and things like that. So the only things that are actually working now in all of media, even traditional media, are the things that are tied into social in a deep way and that let people take the media, connect with it, and share it with other people in their lives and make it part of their lives. And I think it's why you're seeing communications and media converge in a big way, because the way that media is going to matter in the future is going to be about how it lets people connect with each other, and it's going to be less about just people consuming some pre-made thing. It's going to be more of a service and less of a product. And it will take 5 years, 10 years for these things to fully unfold. The print companies that have been trying for 20 years to switch to digital still get most of their revenue from print. The television companies that get most of their revenue from broadcast and cable are still going to get most of their revenue from broadcast and cable 5 years from now, maybe longer than that. But if you stay true to the internet, if you embrace the internet, if you embrace the consumer advantages it provides, and if you make things that that lean into these kinds of advantages, in the long run, you're going to win. In the long run, the internet always wins.